Shalom to Dani, Dayan, former Consul General of Israel in New York.
Shalom, Yanni.
So first of all, we see here the picture of the new government. You were also involved in the politics as part of the New Hope party. Are you pleased with this new government?
Well, I don't think that was the dream of anyone, but I think that is the best option that the complicated results of the last elections provided us. I wholeheartedly supported the formation of the government, and I am, our party is called New Hope. I am hopeful. I have new hopes that this government will deliver.
And when you see the new prime minister, he was, of course, the director of Moetzet Yesha when you were the head of Moetzet Yesha.
Yeah, actually, I brought him back to the political arena because I was looking for a director general, for executive director for Moetzet Yesha, for the Yesha Council. And I remember that there is this young, very energetic and very talented guy that was the chief of staff for Benjamin Netanyahu as head of the opposition. I called him. He told me that he's now, he just started to run a new high-tech startup company. A new startup company, and he cannot accept my request to come. But then 2 days later, he phoned back and asked for a meeting. We met at the Dan Hotel in New York. I remember very vividly that meeting, and the rest history.
One of the things that he says to the right-wing voters is that this government will be even more right-wing, more nationalist than Netanyahu's government. Do you see that happening?
I'm not sure. I think that this government is a kind of compromise. The most important factor that will decide whether this government will succeed or fail is the understanding that I hope that each component of this government, when arriving to a decision-making junction, will think about the sensibilities and the red lines of the other component. If they do that way, they will succeed. If otherwise, they will be very problematic.
Now, President Rivlin is flying to America. Probably the Prime Minister will be flying soon. How do you see the relations between Israel and the United States in this new era? There's no more Trump, no more Netanyahu, for now.
I think that I am quite optimistic. That doesn't mean that we are not going to have differences of opinion. We will. But I think that there is a curiosity in Washington towards the new government, towards Mr. Bennett and Mr. Lapid. And they come without the extra burden on their shoulders that Netanyahu had as being so identified with the GOP, with the Republican Party. So I think that we start in we had a very positive starting point. The phone call by President Biden to Prime Minister Bennett merely 2 or 3 hours after his inauguration, his swearing in, is very indicative.
Some are worried. They say Netanyahu was the only one who knew how to stand for Israel in front of Obama. Could it be that actually a new plate and a new page is good for all sides?
I think so. Look, we have a common interest. Israel and the Biden administration have a common interest, and that interest is to weaken the radical wing in the Democratic Party. I think it's an Israeli interest, and I think also it's a Biden interest. I don't think that there is a similarity between Mr. President Biden and President Obama. Those that say that the Biden administration, first administration, is the third term of Barack Obama are dead wrong. I think it's more similar to Bill Clinton. We had our differences of opinion with Bill Clinton, but we did not have the type of clashes that we had with President Obama.
Dani, we're hearing your name as a candidate for the chairman, the new chairman of the Jewish Agency. You interested?
Yeah, I was approached both by Israelis and Americans in that respect. It will be a great honor to succeed the president of the State of Israel, Isaac Herzog, in that position. I am definitely considering it because, the issue of Jewish peoplehood is really in my blood and bones. I am very passionate about the cohesion of the Jewish people.
What are the missions today?
I think that, there are two extra mitzvahs that we have in this Jewish generation. One is to maintain Israel, of course, as a strong and thriving Jewish state, and the other, understanding that unfortunately millions of Jews are not making Aliyah immediately in the coming years, is to guarantee the continuity of Jewish life elsewhere. And the most important thing for me is to guarantee a cross-responsibility, that Israelis will see themselves responsible for Israel, but also for their brethren across the ocean, and Jews in the world will see themselves responsible for their Jewish life, but also for the state of Israel. That will be my mission if I am elected.
Okay, Dani Dayan, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.